C'est ici, je me rappelle.
The doors of Quebec were like that before, and then people wanted to destroy the wall of Quebec, and the governor said, yes, not much at this time of the year, but during the summer, sometimes a lot, they have to be single inside this building here.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, team will walk across.
Inside the shooting gallery, and we would run in the tunnel, and then at the far end we low our head, but the enemy don't know and hit his head. So don't forget to low your head at the end of the tunnel, okay?
The secret weapon.
Watch your head.
Enemy hidden. Sometimes there were even washroom in a
fireplace, so you can stay here for a while. You can try to guess where we are on the map. I want to give you a hint, it's scratched where we are.
Oh, it's scratched.
And even a theater. And in 1920, when the Royal 22nd Regiment arrived here, it became their headquarters. And headquarters in French is Quartier Général, you see on the grand observation. c'est sur la porte là-bas, vous allez voir que la couronne n'est pas pareille. La couronne d'Edouard, je crois là-bas.
You remember I told you that inside the museum there were 24 soldiers per barrack for one fireplace. Here for two windows, one officer, one fireplace. That's why there's a lot of chimneys on top here. Okay.
Very difficult for Santa Claus. And now the only one who continues the tradition to live on site here is the commanding officer of the Royal 22nd Regiment. And he comes lives here for 2 years mandatory. Okay. So sometimes he comes with his family, so there's a family of children living here. No. Only the second floor, you see the captain.
See the bills?
Often. My wife went 6 times this year. I didn't make it.
Oh, I had to work too much. So I held
they just got eliminated.
Yeah.
We'll get there.
This is an exhibit. Eric Côté, the guy there, he is a photographer, and he followed the regiment for a year and a half. Oh. And there's a documentary about that, about this exhibit. It's called Fortress Vivante, the Citadel, Alive Fortress. You can put that on YouTube. And, so the Orléans, Etampiers, on the 3rd of July is the anniversary of Quebec, so they go in front of City Hall and they.
On the 4th of July?
The 3rd of July. So that's Baptiste IV. Passed away in 1984. Aww. We keep it because it's the ancestor of all the Baptists we had after
yeah.
that.
Before that, Vanier was a very Catholic guy. He was supposed to be a priest, and then he decided to enroll, and he went to the Vendôme, all the big battles for the First World War. And then at Cherissy battle, he lost his right leg. And he came back here to enroll again, like that. Huh? And they say, Monsieur Vanier, how are you going to fight without a leg? He says, maybe I don't have a leg, but you need soldiers with head. And then they
had 4,000 and more barrels.
Was much bigger than the other one, the French one.
That's why it's in the soil, right? And very far from other buildings.
So here is a saluting area, so whenever soldiers pass here, they have to salute like that. What they are saluting is the Vimy Cross right there. Vimy is a very important battle for Canada Nation. They say that the Canada Nation was born in Vimy.
Just the Vimy Ridge.
The Vimy Ridge is in northeast of France. And from the Vimy Ridge, you can see 30 kilometers of France. And behind Vimy Ridge, there was coal mine. So the Germans, they took Vimy Ridge at the first year of the First World War, 1914. Allies. British and French tried to take back Vimy Ridge and they lost 150,000 men trying to do it. So they were not able to take it.